All right.
The last chance for MVP, sending out their random player, Guinea Pig.
Yeah, this is the real random.
Shouldn't they have
King
tested
Man.
It first?
No.
Before sending out as their final player?
He's their guinea pig, but this guinea pig has been through so many tests. It's like a mutant, powerful guinea pig. It can shoot lasers. It's got giant muscles. This guinea pig is ready to go, man.
It's not a regular guinea pig. It's the most valuable pig, the MVP.
That's right. That is exactly right, and they're going to duke it out on Metalopolis. Can Clyburns take on the guinea pig? We should just call him TSL Clyburns.
Well, his Clyburns are looking pretty solid here, man.
They are. They're back. They're reformed like a Category 5 Hurricane. Let's see what it can bring. I wonder if there ever was a Hurricane Clyde.
There was, I think.
Oh. Here's a Hurricane Clyde. And his name is... Mr.
MVP Guinea Piggle.
Oh, that's actually not Clyde. Whoops. All right.
Well, we know what race Guinea Pig is now.
I guess so. Maybe next time I'll actually look at the top of the screen and see who I'm looking at. That'd be a good idea, wouldn't it? I don't know. The left side of the map, this guy from the team TSL. Can he all kill? He is.
TSL, Clyde.
Clydeburns. There they are.
Yeah, it's like a... That's like a Category 4 Clyburn. I think it could go further.
It could.
It Once really it reaches could. The Chen, that's when it reaches Category 5.
Yeah, that's true. That's a good point. He's got a little ways to go.
He goes to get a haircut. The woman asks him if he wants to cut his sideburn. He goes, "Do you know who I am?"
He just looks at her, and she faints.
The Clyburns like start moving, and she's like, "Oh." The Clyburn actually tells her,
"They turn into
no, don't cut me," and she freaks out.
They turn into spirals, start rotating, and it hypnotizes her. And he gets a free haircut. These are just some of the many things that Clyburns can do.
Well, Clyde is taking a gas, whereas it looks like his opponent is going to be going for a one-rax expand.
Yep.
This is something that you can really easily do as a random player, because your opponent doesn't know what race you are right from the start.
Yeah, it kind of forces your opponent to play safe. It really does. And Guinea Pig definitely uses that. Look, he just barely starts a supply depot. Now he's going to go in and finish it. Just doesn't want to let anything in the base. And no gas yet for Guinea Pig either. He could be one racks expanding. He does like to play very... They're handing out burgers!
What?
All right, back to the game. Anyway, sorry, that was just very traumatic for me.
This has happened before.
It has. Clyde could be one rex expanding. That's the most likely thing. I'm sorry, Guinea Pig could be. Guinea Pig does like to play for an economic style, despite being a random player.
Yeah, exactly. That's one thing I was going to say.
Or, he's putting down a command center. I was going to say, or he could put down five more barracks and just be great. But, nope, there's a command center, I guess.
Yeah, he's going to double gas it as well here, most likely. Yeah, that's one thing I wanted to mention earlier that I forgot to, is that a lot of random players... don't play economic style games, but that's actually the best way to play random, is you can take economic risks.
Yeah.
And your opponent can't really punish you for them initially. You can't do a build that's designed to punish someone. You can't go, oh, well, it's not like playing against a player who normally fast expands, like Nesty.
And, So, it looks like we're, well, it's kind of like you were saying, you know?
We just got some bulgogi burgers, man. I was trying to tell him that I didn't want one, but you wanted one, but you got confused by my hand signals.
Yeah.
But then now I have one too, so I guess we both have bulgogi burgers.
Well, we're not going to eat them.
We're not going to eat them.
Don't worry. Don't worry about it. So as you were saying, MVP Guinea Pig is definitely using that advantage as a random player to play a more macro game. He's playing random right. That's the best way to put it.
Yeah, because... your opponent can't really factor in that he could go for a one barracks expand until he sees that you're a Terran, and then if the wall is blocked off with depots and he really doesn't know what's going on, it's just very difficult to plan for something like that.
He's going to need to use a scan, and he doesn't want to do that at this phase in the game. He's actually just going to be going for what looks to be a blue flame Hellion drop. So Clyde basically saying, well, really no matter what you're doing, this could do damage. So, I think that's a good decision by Clyde. We'll have to see how it all pans out.
Sorry, it's just like the bulgogi burgers are such a distraction.
I'm completely focused right now. I don't know what you're talking about.
I like can smell it. You can smell it too. You're just like trying to be focused. You like keep looking at
we,
it.
You know, we intentionally like starved ourselves today somehow. It was like unintentional actually. We haven't just haven't eaten a lot today.
Yeah, it's just sometimes what happens.
Yeah.
With our schedule. Well, guinea pig scans. Unfortunately for him though, he's not able to see anything that Clyde is up to. He didn't see. He saw neither the blue flame hellions nor the expansion. So, he actually got nothing out of that scan.
Nope. Which is kind of interesting.
Clyde's hellions have been lifted. They may Clyde burn down all of those SCVs.
They certainly could. Dude, Torch just literally stole the bulgogi burger right off the desk. I'm not even kidding.
Well, I had mine hidden below
you
the
did.
Desk, so he couldn't get mine.
You were smart. You, like, burrowed yours. I just left mine out in the open. He took it. He took it away from me.
Don't worry, we can split mine.
All
everything
right.
will be fine.
This is a lot of drama. I don't need to deal with one. I'm trying to cast a GSL, man.
Well, here come these Hellions. He's actually going to drop just one on the outside.
That's really good. He gets a nice scout close to Venus.
Oh, yeah.
The front.
Draws the Marines forward.
Oh, he could just drop right behind the mineral line, too.
I think dropping in the main would be a great idea, though, given that the
yeah.
Marines are all on the low ground. Here they come.
He's going to get Clyde burned.
He's going to get Clyde burned.
And a lot of SCVs dying.
And these Marines lining up. He's
yeah.
actually going to attack
Whoa.
The Marines.
Guinea pig, what are you doing with those Marines, man?
He did decide to split them later, but it's a little too late for that. There's just no...
It is.
The Marine count he has isn't
Look
enough.
Look at that micro, too.
Meanwhile, though, a Banshee flies into Clyde's base.
Uh-oh.
There's no answer for that.
Oh, look at that. The SCVs are getting clumped up. There is a Banshee in Clyde's base right now, but the real story is the Banshee at Clyde's base right now, apparently.
That's the real story.
That's the real
and
story.
And Clyde made his own Banshee to follow this up with, so he did not make a Viking.
Yep.
Which is the, you know, the riskier thing to do in this case, but he does have a Viking on the way. He can't just transfer his SCVs to the natural because the Banshee can attack both locations.
Yeah. Nice Banshee micro keeping it alive despite the Marines there killing a lot of SCVs, but he does eventually need to make it.
Oh, man. At the natural, you guys can get a shot of it. All of the SCVs got Clyde burned.
Oh,
all of them, except three. Three of them survived.
Oh,
but they're going to die now.
This game is so violent.
And look at those.
Wow.
Clyde says, nice Clyde burns that I gave you.
You got Clyde burns.
You guys want to know what the SCV count is? 19 for Clyde, 2 for Guinea Pig.
Well,
just 2.
You can't do very much off of 2 SCVs. It's up to 3 now. It doesn't really change a lot of things.
Those Hellions are denied entrance to the base. They have to leave.
Those, you know, they need to install those, like, jump things that they have on Speed Racer's car.
Oh, man, that was... Yeah. You said jump, and, like, my mind went there. Like, I didn't
I
think
know.
That's what you were going to say, but my mind went there immediately.
I knew you would think
They
exactly
need the Speed Racer jump jacks. Actually, they should have a Mach 5 upgrade that you can research from the tech lab. Maybe it requires armory, but it's, like, worth it.
That Hellion's going to get taken out by the Vikings.
Now this Banshee wants to do some damage, but fortunately for her, there are 3 Vikings out and 2 turrets up in play.
Yeah.
She may get that one SCV.
Clyde is just so far ahead. I mean, there's... I don't know what Guinea Pig really thinks he's going to be able to do at this point.
There's really nothing more he can do.
Yeah. It's sad. It's sad, of his, but it's true. He could maybe go for Cloak. Hope to get really lucky, I guess. You can see that he's kind of expecting Clyde to do kind of a standard Marine tank push after this. He's trying to get some Vikings and Banshees out, but Clyde's not going to do it. He's already got the air advantage. He's like, well, I don't even really need tanks. I can just push ahead with Hellions and whatever else I have. I can just throw whatever I've got at him, and that should work.
It's true. Clyde's got 4 Vikings to the 3 Vikings of Guinea Pig.
Yeah.
So even if they have a battle, Clyde's going to win that one.
Yep, certainly will.
Plus, he's got more Marine support. And this bunker only has 1 Marine. It's the only thing standing between victory and the Clyde. The Clyde.
It's the Clyde.
The Clyde.
Isn't it ironic the day that Clyde is really the champion? Tasis and Artosis are nowhere to be seen.
I know, man. They're going to wish they were casting this one. Hellion poking out of depot. He's trying to target down the Banshee. And again, Guinea Pig denied mining at his natural.
Yeah. I mean... Guinea Pig's a good player. But even good players are...
Even good players run into Clyde.
Yep, that's right.
Good and this is going to be it for the air advantage. Asserting that, but Banshee is going to work on these Marines.
Yeah,
he needs to target those down with the Vikings.
Well, that's kind of what we were saying, is that Guinea Pig could figure out a way to do some damage, and that Viking is actually Clyde's last Viking at the moment.
And these Hellions going to clean up everything!
Oh, man. More Hellions killing more SCVs. Guinea Pig staying safe for now with the Banshees, but you know, he's only got 15 SCVs to the 43 of Clyde. If Guinea Pig wins this, that will actually be amazing. I think Clyde's sideburns will abandon him and actually jump on Guinea Pig if that happens.
Yeah, that would be a sight to see.
Yeah, it's because they're going to abandon their owner. It's like the One Ring, you know?
Very
true. It's like I need to find someone who's more capable.
Nice splitting of the Hellions there by Guinea Pig so that he didn't take any extra damage, but those Hellions are going to meet two other Hellions. And it's not a pleasant meeting. They actually were accosted by those other aliens. That's what really happened.
Met them in a dark alien Metalopolis.
Oh, is the SCV going to die? Aww.
It
SCV
did.
Die. He's going to have to bring another one to finish that command center.
Oh, check this out. Clyde is adding on two more starports, too.
Yeah, he needs to. He just realizes that he might as well.
Yeah.
If he gets the air advantage, he can just do whatever he wants. Look at this. He's going to clean up. The Clyde burn will commence.
Guinea Pig is like, well, I guess I'm going to lose all my SCVs again.
Yeah, this is looking good. 52 to 13 at this point. Look at that worker's kill tab.
It's got 62 of them right now. That's pretty impressive.
Just cranking out Vikings only at this point.
And now he's going to lose a lot of his SCVs.
Yeah, there's so many Banshees to deny this, but even so, Clyde finds a way.
Yeah.
And look at this. He's got another dropship set up. But unfortunately for him, that's going to be spotted.
Uh-oh. He's going to need to drop those off. Oh! Losing two Hellions there in the dropship. Medivac.
Medivac was accosted this time.
Yep.
Well, with four starports, one of those with the reactor, Clyde's got constantly, at a time, he can make five Vikings.
He's got his Raven. As soon as he has enough for point defense drone, it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, 11 to 4 Viking count. Both players with the Raven, but all that matters is that Clyde has one.
Clyde's just cruising to victory right now. You know, I wish I could say that Guinea Pig, you know, had a chance yet, but he really doesn't.
He doesn't have a chance, man.
Yeah.
Clyde is just going to assert that air dominance, continue to do so. I'm surprised he hasn't added a fusion core yet. I think he wants to make a finale. I just feel like that's where this is going, man.
Clyde's finest hour.
Point defense run goes down.
Yeah, and as all the Vikings die, we should see a GG Guinea Pig here.
Yeah, and in fact, there wasn't even a point defense drone for Guinea Pig. He didn't have enough energy yet.
Yep.
The one Banshee of Clyde shaking things up. Even a Clyde mule.
It's a Clyde mule.
And Guinea Pig drops his own. GG! Clyde all kills!
Yes,
the entire
Clyde.
Team!
Look at that. He's like smoothing his sideburns down. He's like, thank you. I'd like to thank my sideburns. Guinea Pig. I love this guy. I think he's a great player.
He is a great player. Clyde just was too much for him.
Yeah. Clyde's too much for everybody today, man. I mean, nobody can handle Clyde. Killer's
he's like Killer.
Killer's like, I've given you enough of my powers already.
The coach is like he's like actually asking him to turn in his Clyde burns. He's like, no, I won't. I won't turn them in. I have to keep them.
Yep.
He's becoming possessed by the power of the Clyde burns.
Becoming intoxicated by the power, Wolf. Hey, look, it's our fans. Actually, they might not be our fans. Maybe they're. We'll pretend that they are.
I like that face that he made. That was kind of intense.
He was like, I'm on camera.
He did hold up a cheerful earlier. He's quite the fan.
That was just the face that everybody makes when they see Clyde play. It's just how it is. I don't know. I haven't like jumped on the Clyde bandwagon in the past, but I might have to now.
He has been getting better and better as time has gone on.
Yeah, he has. And entertaining at the same time. It's great.
Now we're going to see our new results. Clyde!
Clyde.
I don't know. I'm trying
Clyde.
To like think of a like verb for that. He like clid through. I don't know.
I don't know if that sounds good. It's Clyded.
He Clyded through today.
I think Clyde burned is the most apt description.
Yeah.
Clyde burning his way through Monster, Dongrigu, Vampire, and Guinea Pig, the whole Monster Menagerie. Someone actually tweeted at me. They were like, Frankenstein's not actually the monster. It's Dr. Frankenstein. And the monster isn't a mummy. I know, they're two separate things, okay? I know that Dr. Frankenstein didn't make the mummy. Seriously. But here's the thing. The monster is also Frankenstein. Otherwise, you don't see, like, a doctor on the box of Frankenberry, do you? Come on, people. Seriously.
He just wants to let you guys know. It's true. Don't question Doe. He knows what he's talking about. He talks about Frankenstein.
Well, technically, it is Dr. Frankenstein, and it's Frankenstein's monster, not Frankenstein. But colloquially, Frankenstein is the name of the monster.
Well, sort of Frankenstein too. Created MVP Monster.
That's true. He's Frankenstein's monster. That's right. And he ended up being Zerg. Who knew?
Yeah, who knew?
Yeah. I suppose. Man, now I really want, like, Frankenberry and Count Chocula and all those great, like, monster-themed cereals. That was a lot of fun.
That reminds me of Candyland.
Candyland?
I don't know why. It just reminds me of Candyland for
reminded
some reason.
Reminded me of Urkelos, but my mind is in a completely different place right now.
Candyland was such a bad game. You would get lucky and land on the Rainbow Road, and the game would just be over from that point.
I know. It's interview time, guys. Let's see what Clyde has to say.
TSL팀을 만나보도록 하겠습니다. 자, TSL팀의 오늘의 MVP 선수는 바로 한규정 선수입니다. 네, 축하드려요.
감사합니다.
네, 마지막 경기를 네. 올킬로 멋지게 장식했단 말이죠. 올킬 네. 예상하고 나오셨나요?
전혀 예상하지 못했어요. 저는 정말 상상도 못했어요.
상상도 못했는데 네. MVP 선정되셨는데
1경기만
네. He says, I didn't imagine 네. even in my dreams that I would be able to all-kill today.
네, 운도 실력입니다. 정말 축하드리고요. 두 번째 세트에서 박소
선수가 I think I was a little bit lucky today.
박소 선수가 나왔는데 또 박소 선수한테 첫 패배를 안겨줬어요. 네. 그 박소 선수가 나올 거라고 또 예상을 하셨을 텐데 어떻게 데뷔하고 준비를 하셨나요?
아, 사실 본인이 나온다고 했어요. 아. 경기 시작하기 전에 두 번째 주자로 본인이 나온다고 얘기를 해서 생각은 하고 있었는데 뭐 연습을 하거나 그러진 않았어요.
Oh, I guess he says Dongryu told me that he would be coming out second during the match so that I should be prepared.
잘 된 것 같아요. 운이 정말 좋았네요.
네, 즉흥적으로 네. 했는데 MVP까지 선정되셔 대단하십니다. 네, 제가 한규종 선수 어떤 인터뷰에서 자신은 뭐 엄청나게 우승을 많이 한 선수보다는
He says that I didn't prepare specifically for Dongryu, but and I feel like I got a little bit lucky in that match. And he says I'm glad I'm the first person to beat Dongryu in the GSTL. I don't know if that's actually true.
몇 없는 제 팬 여러분들
I'm not going to question his pride.
오늘 올킬하게 되어서 너무 기분 좋고요. 응원 많이 해주셔서 감사드립니다. 앞으로도 좋은 모습 보여드리겠습니다. 감사합니다.
네,
thanks to my fans for supporting my team and also myself.
자, 그리고 감독님 말씀을 들어보지 않을 수가 없습니다. 5전 전승 정말 대단한데요. 기분이 어떠신가요?
지금 제 감정은 어떤 것도 형용할 수 없을 정도로 너무 기쁘고요. 네. 팀원들에게 너무 감사하고 팬분들에게 너무 감사합니다.
Says I'm so happy. It's hard to express my feelings right now.
네. 오늘 선봉으로 한규정 선수를 내세워주셨는데 한규정 선수가 GSTL에서는 그동안 보기 힘들었던 선수인란 말이죠. 특별히 뭐 이유가 있는지 네, 궁금합니다.
한규정 선수가 좀 책임감이 책임감이 엄청
높거든요.
근데 본인이 나가서 혹시라도 1패를 할 경우에 딱 그냥 단지 1패일 뿐인데 한규정 선수가 본인이
Clyde felt 2패, 3패 A lot of pressure playing in the GSTL as opposed to just regular GSL matches. I guess.
극복하고자 본인의 선봉을 꼭 출전하고 싶다 이렇게 의사를 표현해서 좋은
좋은 결과 나와서
So Clyde wanted to improve in that aspect, so that's why the coach wanted him to play first today.
각오한 말씀 해주시죠.
지금 여섯 명에서
예, also a microphone.
I know, man. Clyde's actually just perfect at everything.
He knows everything. He's actually is the perfect human being.
여기에 만족하지 않고.
I won't doubt anymore.
일단 우승을 하려면 일단 전승을 해야 되는 거니까 꼭 전승 우승을 할 수 있도록 여섯 명 선수와 신입 선수들.
Our goal is to win the championship, so we're not going to be satisfied with our win so far.
네, 전승 기록 이어 나가길 저도 바라겠습니다. 고맙습니다.
네, 감사합니다.
We'll
자,
오늘의
오늘 승리팀이죠. TSL팀을 만나봤습니다.
Wow, so there you have it. Big day for Clyde.
And TSL,
really
man.
Well. Yeah, TSL too. They're undefeated
5-0.
This season. That's awesome. They're going to have like the book printed about the season and everything at the end of it. And the brackets at the end, the playoffs are single elimination, so they're going to have to win all the rest of their games if they're going to get to the finals.
It would be crazy if they were able to go all the way through the finals completely undefeated.
Yeah.
A team that
historically has not done extremely well in GSTL. Its players even haven't done really well in the GSL itself either.
Yeah.
To come, and they're just so close-knit. Coach Lee is obviously a very smart coach. He makes all the right decisions. I think that's really why they've succeeded so well.
Yeah, let's take a look at our standings right now, of course.
Plus 13.
Wow.
Unlucky number to join in on, but...
Unlucky number for the rest of the teams we see there.
Yeah,
obviously,
man.
MVP and Prime are making it to the playoffs. OGSTL, F United, and Slayers sadly do not. But, wow, 5-0. Is there anybody that can touch TSL?
I guess we'll have to find out in the playoffs if some of these other teams from the Venus Division can show their stuff.
We will. We will, Wolf.
Shall.
We shall. We will and shall.
Speaking of the Venus Division, that will be on tomorrow. It'll be cast by Tastosis.
Yep.
Voyou versus Startail. There's a lot of specific intricacies that go into that matchup.
Oh my gosh. I know what just happened today. Tastosis and Artosis are actually at home sleeping right now. They're dreaming of Clyde all killing in the GSTL. Their dreams are starting to affect reality. It's happening, Wolf.
Could really be the case.
It's happening. Either that or we're all incepted and this is actually like in their dreams. Who knows? But yeah, don't miss that tomorrow,
the top
guys.
Stop spinning.
That is actually a big match tomorrow because that match could decide those teams' future in the GSTL as well.
Yeah, it's so complicated actually what happens between these two guys. I don't even want to get into it right now. I'm sure Nick and Dan will tell you all about it tomorrow.
Yes, that's right. So that's going to do it about for today. Thanks for joining us, guys. We had some really exciting games, really cool matchups. TSL, I mean, those were great games. I mean, you get to watch them again this weekend. That's a good thing to kind of keep in mind is definitely watch a lot of VODs this weekend. There's a lot of great stuff in the history of the GSL. It's been almost a year now, a couple days shy of that.
Yeah, and make sure you watch the Code A qualifiers as
Absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely.
That's going to be broadcast on Saturday and Sunday. So please, yep. please watch that. It's going to be pretty much going on all day here in Korea, so all night for you guys in the U.S., some of you. So just whenever you've got a chance, tune in, watch that. We're going to have as much coverage for you guys as possible. So see you all next time. I am Wolf. With me is Doa. This is the GSTL.